Recognise this guy? He's everywhere. The government earmarked $50 million to celebrate his arrival on Australian shores.
Given that there are already 110 statues of Cook in Australia, maybe that $50 million could be repurposed to building a hell of a lot of statues of a great diversity of Australian women.
Professor Claire Wright is an historian.
So appallingly, there are fewer than 4% of Australian statues that represent a real historic named woman. In Melbourne, there is only 1%.
Claire says there's been a distinct reluctance to put women on a pedestal.
That's aside from statues of Queen Victoria. There are a few of those.
It's really disappointing considering we've had so many powerful women. It's really upsetting actually.
Throughout history, women have just been grossly underrepresented. So it's kind of just like, it's not surprising.
The statue that I'm standing next to now is the most common type of statue of a woman in Australia and indeed around the world. She's faceless, she's naked, which is typical. This woman becomes a muse to a male creativity, to a male gaze, to an idea of what a woman should be, what she should represent.
Claire acknowledges that Melbourne has been making an effort recently to correct the gender balance.
There's one of Nova Peris, there's one of Kylie Minogue, and there's one of Taylor Harris. But the great shame about these statues is they don't actually have a permanent place of residence.
Meaning they're denied access to pigeons and the public.
They basically just get shunted around from place to place or literally put in a shed waiting for them to have a permanent home.
The nation's capital has been no help in setting a non-sexist example.
There are no full-bodied statues of real historic women in Canberra's parliamentary zone. There are statues of dogs. Very recently, we had a statue of John Gorton and his dog, but no statues of women.
So good to know we've got enough dog statues, and of course we have big fruit sorted too. But where will we see more women? After nearly 80 years, Canberra has finally decided to immortalise Dame Enid Lyons and Dame Dorothy Tangi, the first two women elected to federal parliament.
We need to see more of it, and we need to see it happening quicker.
Today it's been announced that Pauline Mensah, Byron Bay's school bus driver and 1993 world surfing champ, will be honoured with a statue at her home break of Bondi. That's once enough money has been raised to pay for it.
So I think it would be a great disruptive element to place Pauline Mensah there on that board, to put a strong woman who just absolutely not only conquered the waves but conquered the world.
I'd like to see Julia Gillard in Melbourne. I'm a big fan.
No one really wants to see a statue of James Cook anymore. People want to see Grace Tame. They want to see the women that are inspiring us now.
If there's one person on this earth that deserves a statue here in Australia, it's Sampa the Great. Hands down.
Well, maybe we could come up with something even more inspiring than statues.
Oh, you're right. What would you like?
Well, I feel like there's something, I don't know, have the alternative, but more lively.
Right.
Even like art, graffiti art,
yeah,
or something.
Right.
I feel like there's something about the statue that's also set in the past.
Mm. Yeah, I get that. But isn't that the power of it, though? Because there's something about a statue that speaks of kind of like a... like an official...
I mean, the Statue of Liberty,
recognition.
That's the most famous one in the world.
That
and it's
is
all,
true,
you
that
know?
Is true.
That is true.
You'd think we would have copied that.
I was thinking Edith Cowan. I'm really surprised there's no Edith Cowan. Mm. So we heard there are the two women who were the first federal parliamentarians, but she was the first in any parliament in Australia. And I just would have thought that'd have to be somewhere, wouldn't it? Mm.
I would have thought even at the university, perhaps.
Yeah, possibly.
But no.
Well, maybe you only get a university. You get one or the other.